Hello all. In today's lecture, we'll try to know much about review paper. Okay, at the student level, it becomes a tough task to select a topic. Once you select the topic and select a specific area where you work on, I'll give you an example also. Then we need to work on the literature firstly. We need to write or publish a review paper first, which is an indication that you have a previous search or research on papers or journals. Okay. For example, today we'll discuss about materials. Under this material, let us talk about composite materials. Composite materials, which is a boom in today's scenario because most of the traditional components or materials are replaced by composites, okay, which are naturally available, natural fibers, what you call, with the help of some matrices, you can fabricate the material to create any of the component or to fabricate any of the component, okay, much under existence. If your area is composite materials, then again, as we discussed in our previous lecture, that it is again divided, I mean, classified broadly into metal matrix, ceramic matrix, metal, ceramic, and polymer. Okay. Now, as I have discussed in the previous lecture, that it all depends on the person who is going to work or research, like whether he can invest such big amount or not, what are all the different tests he want to perform, and whether the material is available near by him or not. All these things need to be keep in mind first. Okay. Based on that, let us imagine that, or let us assume, selected polymer as the topic. Under polymers, you find natural fibers and you need to use different matrices. Okay, now under polymers, again, for example, let us consider I have selected some X1 as material. I'm not going to take any names. X2 as second material, X3 as third material. Okay, I've selected three different, then composite means the name itself indicates it is a combination of two or more than two. Okay, if you mix together individually, it has very good properties, and when you mix, the strength level may enhance, it may double, it may triple in some cases. That is the reason we'll go with multi layers. Okay, these are the parameters or factors what you call X1, X2, X3. Let us imagine these are different natural fibers we have chosen. Okay, now our idea is to fabricate the material. To fabricate material, we need to select a matrix. Matrix is need to be selected. Now this matrix is of two types, epoxy type and polyester. Okay, these are the matrices. Some other are also available. Now these are under much existence. Okay, epoxy and polyester resins, what you call. Okay, these two are resins. It acts as an adhesive to join two polymers together, and we need to mix in proper proportions. Okay, these two acts as matrices, and X1, X2, X3 maybe act as reinforcing material. Reinforce material, all X1, X2, X3. Okay, we need to mix in proper proportion. Now, again, this particular matrix or resin consists of we need to use one more agent called hardener, resin plus hardener. Okay, in proper proportion, mixing in proper proportion is very much required. And whenever you talk about epoxy and polyester, it won't be of same grade. The chemical is a mixture of different combinations. When you purchase from the market, you will get that particular specifications also. Those specifications also very much important when you publish a paper, whether it is a review or a work paper. Okay, even the specifications related to x1, x2, x3 is also very much important. We need to save it for our future purpose to publish a paper. Okay, simply you can't buy it and you can't leave all the other specifications. Okay, now specifications nothing but, for example, you have purchased a mat made of natural fiber. This mat has been purchased from some X person. When you purchase, he'll give you the complete specifications related to this particular mat, like what is the gauge size, okay, what is the grain size or gauge size, followed by what is the diameter of the fiber, diameter or gauge or grade. Okay, all these are very much important because the mats are available with different grades. That is also important, that information need to be saved. Okay, now coming back to review paper, we are specified our area, like polymers we are working on to x1 x2 x3, and these are the matrix. Out of this matrix, let us consider for today's topic epoxy is the resin we have chosen, followed by epoxy hardener. Epoxy resin, epoxy hardener is our selection. Okay, these are the selections. Now these are called as matrices. These are reinforcing materials. Okay, now it has become hybrid because I'm using three different parameters or factors. Okay, once this is done, how to write a research paper? Because we are directly not fabricating the material, and we are not directly getting the strength properties or mechanical or physical properties of that particular fabricated material. Okay, before that, before actually purchasing it, this is our idea, actual idea. Before actually purchasing it, what we need to know is whether the work has already been performed on these materials or not. That should be our first question. Okay, we need to search for whether the work has already been performed on x1 x2 x3 by using epoxy hardener and epoxy resin. Is there existing work is there or not? We need to search for it. First search is our first finding should be like whether x1 x2 x3 and resin plus hardener, what we have chosen, is a unique one or not. Whether some X person is already working or already they have worked and published a paper, that we need to recheck. Okay, second task, once this is done, no past work is there based on same scenario, then what we need to do is, secondly, we can make sure that yes, we can confine to this area now, followed by these materials. Once you confine to that area, you need to download papers, research articles from top reputed journals like Elsevier or Springer or Tyler and Francis, or many other publications are there, top most. From there, you need to collect information based on X1. X1, let us consider X1 as a material called jute. Okay, for your understanding, jute. What I try to do is, I'll try to gather information based on this X1 jute for past maybe 10 years. Past 10 years information, I'll try to collect it. Okay, and collecting information should also be done in this way. Like, for example, for your better understanding, what I try to do is, let us consider you are working on a monitor, you are working on your PC. Okay, maybe you have a specific folder in this. What I try to do is, when I'm working on jute, I'll try to create a folder based on jute. Okay, under this jute, again I'll create subfolders. I'll create subfolders for papers which I have collected for past 10 years. Maybe papers based on mechanical properties, papers based on characterization, papers based on maybe different coatings. Okay, similarly, maybe papers based on different comparative analysis. Papers based on maybe FEA analysis. Okay, likewise, we need to collect different papers and we need to keep accordingly in different folders. Now, keeping your work in different folders is very much essential because you are segregating all the documents, whatever you have collected. You may collect in this particular 10 years, you may collect some 100 or 200 documents, or maybe in few cases 3, 4, 500 documents also. In such scenario, segregating them all after downloading is a big task again. Again, once you, the time when you download, try to keep in different folders based on the work they have performed or based on the essence of that particular work. Once this is done, you need to do the same task for X1, X2, X3. Okay. And in case of resins also, resin hardener also, try to gather some papers related. Okay, how does it help past work and all. Once this is done, third step, third level, what we need to do is try to go through each and every individual paper. Let us imagine that we have downloaded, or you have downloaded some 100 different reputed journals based on this particular X1 material. Okay, paper 1, first paper. Okay, you need to go through the complete paper and what is said in the objective or what is said in the abstract and how he has concluded, in what way he has concluded, what are the findings. Okay, findings you need to mention with the help of conclusion and results and discussion. Conclusion and results and discussion. Similarly, paper number 2, do the same process. Paper number 3, do the same process. Okay, now you can make a negative point also. Negative point can also be made. Okay, so he has said some X paper has in the abstract they have mentioned few and so X things, but those were not properly convinced in the conclusion. Okay, that kind of statement can also be made, and further future scope, whatever he has mentioned, that can also be presented in your reviewing. Okay, followed by the author names and title and year of publication, volume and papers from where to where those got published in that particular volume. Okay, everything has to be mentioned properly. This information has to be gathered. This is very much important at the third level. And coming to the fourth level, now keeping side headings, try to maintain side headings for a specific work or specific, you know, area of work, whatever you are segregating. Okay, while creating your review paper, that is also very much important. Okay, side headings, and you need to segregate all relevant papers in that under that particular side headings, followed by the reference number with a square bracket. Okay, all the time the reference number has to be kept in a square bracket. Okay, this is also very much important. Now coming to this particular review paper, should have proper justifying title. Proper justifying title means you are writing review on maybe three different materials or a specific simple material. You are making a critical review, or else you would like to talk about all the three different materials in a single paper. It all depends on the person who doing the review. Okay, if that is the scenario, then you need to gather information based on each and every individual, followed by its reinforcement with other, followed by the matrix they are used, and the essence of that particular paper is also important. Okay, and after title, again there should be abstract. Okay, this abstract should contain some 150 to 200 words which should justify what all the things you are going to write in your review. Okay, for example, we were discussing about composites, that too polymers. Under this polymer area, what is the past work done, and how long, I mean, from past many decades we are using it, for how many decades we are using it, and what are the different natural fibers available, and what is the advantage of using it, and different applications related. After that, specifically, you should come into your work. Like this review, what does this review states about? Like it states about different characterizations, and it also states about different mechanical properties and strength variations of the material. It also gives you information about microstructure of different materials, different polymers, when it got reinforced with some other polymer, and different resins. Okay, so after abstract, you need to start with introduction. Under introduction, you need to write about the importance of composite materials or polymers specifically. Then you need to start with the literature. Okay, no need to go with a separate side heading of a literature. Directly, you can start out with whatever the papers you have collected. Okay, you can start information. Now, after giving small introduction, you can start off with your literature. Under the literature, you need to talk about, for example, if introduction is 1, you need to start off with 1.1 should be your sub side heading. Okay, characterization of polymers, maybe, for example, for your understanding, characterization of polymers. Under this characterization, whatever the 100 papers you have collected, most, maybe few papers talk about characterization, all those papers, maybe 10 papers or 20 papers talk about characterization, those 10 or 20 should come under this category or this subheading. Okay, similarly, the discussion should be something like this. Okay, then again, 1.2, maybe it will talk about mechanical properties. Now, papers related to mechanical properties, maybe like tensile, compression, impact, flexural, finding these properties, that information should come under this particular 1.2. Okay, similarly, if you have some more information related, 1.3. Okay, 1.3, maybe comparison with or reinforcement, different reinforcement under this category. Maybe I have given an example of jute. This jute may merge with some other fiber like banana fiber or coconut coir, some other coirs. Okay, so in such scenario, all different reinforcement should come under this particular category. Okay, all different reinforcement should come under this particular category. And likewise, if you want more number of side headings, you can place them all. Okay, followed by, there should be number 2, conclusion. Okay, under this conclusion, again you need to finalize whatever you have said in the abstract, that need to be justified here in the conclusion, that review of so and so characteristics of so and so material has been done, and it is said that so and so paper has been said this, that need to be written in case of conclusion, followed by if there is any future work that can be performed based on this particular review, that can also be stated here. Future work can also be stated. Okay, number three, this should be your review. Okay, work paper is completely different, or research article is completely different, and this particular review paper is different. Okay, now the most important points to be noted here is, whenever you write a review paper, you need to write a review based on that particular specific paper, not based on the authors. Okay, so you should not use words like he has said so and so thing in so and so X paper, or she has said, okay, like this. Everything should be like past tense. Okay, this, that should not be used in this particular review paper. Fine. So everything should be used in past tense. Okay, past tense means, for example, concluded that tensile strength or mechanical properties of a material is much superior compared to some other X material. Okay, observed, you can use evaluated, examined. Okay, likewise past tense should be used. Okay, and repeatedly don't use same term again and again when you write up. I mean, you are going to write up some 6 to 7 pages of review. Repeatedly don't use. You can use a word like twice in a single paper. Okay, 10-paged or 6-paged review paper. Continuously can't use same term again and again. Also, when it comes to higher level publications, all these terms plays a key role. There should be proper connectivity between literature also. Connectivity should be there. Year wise, you need to write. When you write the subtitle, after writing the subheading also, you'll try to gather characterization information. While doing that also, you need to gather information year wise. Okay, for example, from past 2000 to 2005 information you want to gather, that information has to be presented year wise. Okay, year wise need to be presented. Simply you can't present it the way you want. Okay, these are the few things need to be keep in mind. Always talk about past tense. Okay, now because this is the work performed by some other authors and we are just reviewing it and stating the essence of that particular paper followed by conclusion, that is the reason we never give present tense or future tense here in this particular review paper. Okay, collection of literature is very much important. Okay, followed by complete informations need to be known. Now the paper can be published. Again, same discussion we had in other lectures also. The journals could be paid and free. Free journals, paid journals. Again, try to go with every time try to go with free journals, which will help you out for your career. And means this is the indication that reviewing is done genuinely with all the plagiarized tools properly, and it has published according to the principle or process of or ethics of that particular organization. So your paper values much higher compared to others. So try to always go with free journals, whether you deal with a review paper or else actual work paper. In the upcoming lectures, we are going to talk about actual work paper and many more important points related to research and development area. And thank you for now. Thank you for watching.